In this lesson, we look at an example of a transportation problem that is solved using the stepping stone method, starting from an initial feasible solution obtained using the northwest corner rule. So let's consider this example of a transportation schedule with two supply sources and three destinations, one, two destinations, one, two, and three. So here we'll just go through the solution process. The assumption is that you would have watched the other videos that describe the implementation of the stepping stone method and also the northwest corner rule in finding initial feasible solutions. So let's look at the northwest corner rule solution. So with the northwest corner rule, the starting point is to allocate as much as possible to the cell that is at the northwest corner. So comparing these two numbers, you have to multiply, you have to allocate 40 in the cell from A to 1. So that was you get. Then this column is now full, so you can only go to the next allocation. You have to go to the right and allocate as much as possible. So you allocate 170 there, meaning that the second column is now full. Then you go to this cell and you allocate as much as possible, making sure that the total does not exceed, or the total is exactly equals to 350. So it means that you allocate 140, which is the amount required to add on 170 and 40, so that the total becomes 150. Then the last step is allocating 340 in cell B to 3, so that the total is 480. So that's the allocation for the northwest corner rule. The total cost for this allocation is 6,070. So next, we want to check if this initial feasible solution allocation is optimal. For that, we must evaluate the improvement indices for the empty cells. So, want to find the improvement index for that cell and the second cell. So, starting with the cell B to 1, you draw all, well, you first find the closed path starting from that cell and back to it, putting alternating plus and minus signs where you change directions on the closed path. So, if you start from B1, you put plus 2, then you change direction. Minus 10, change direction, put plus, so that is your closed path for the improvement index from B to 1. Then the improvement index, you just add these numbers, the unit costs which now have the cells. So the improvement index for B to 1 would be plus 2 minus 10 plus 7 minus 4. So from B to 1, the improvement index is minus 5. Then to find the improvement index for the next cell, the cell B to 2, you trace the closed path. So we want to find the improvement index for this cell. So you trace the closed path starting from the cell and back to it. So starting from that cell, you go to the right, then you go up, you go left, then you go back down. So that's the closed path, and the improvement index will be plus 5 minus 10 minus 7. comparing these two improvement indices, it is clear that the cost saving route is the one for this cell. The route from B to 2 would be the cost saving route because it's minus 7, meaning that you will, for each unit that is allocated on that route, you save 20 units, 20 additional units on that route. You minus 7 times 20, which would be 140. So you want to allocate as much as possible on this cost saving route. So how do we then improve the solution by allocating more goods on the cost saving route? So we start from the cost saving route. Now the procedure for improving the solution is, you know, to consider subtracting as much as possible from the cells with negative unit costs, then the amount that is subtracted on from those two cells is added to the cells with plus. So if you compare 170 and 340, then you look for the minimum. The minimum comparing these two numbers is 170. So you subtract 170 on this cell, so you get 0. The amount that is subtracted there, you subtract it also on this cell, you get 170. Then you add the same amount that has been subtracted on the two cells on the cells with plus. So you'll have 170 there. Then you add 170 again on this cell, so you will get 310. So now the revised allocation is given by this new tableau. Then you, if you were to evaluate the total cost of this revised allocation, you'll find that the total cost is 4,880. So next we want to check if this new allocation is optimal. To check for optimality, we must find the improvement indices of the new empty cell. So we must find the improvement index of that cell and that cell. So starting with B1, you trace a closed path on B1. So that is a closed path on B1, and the improvement index associated with B1 is plus 2 minus 10 plus 7 minus 4, which gives minus 5. Then for the second empty cell, that one, the improvement, I mean the closed path, you go down to tracing the closed path, go left, right, up and left. So that's the closed path. The improvement index for that cell is plus 7. Comparing these two improvement indices, we conclude that the cost saving route is the one from B to 1. So we want to revise the allocation by allocating more units on the route B to 1. So that's the cost saving route. Next we look at how the allocation can be revised by allocating more units on the cost saving route. So we start with the cost saving route. Again, the procedure is to subtract as much as possible on the cells with negative. So to do that, you compare the two amounts on these cells, then you subtract the minimum, that is the lower number B1, between the two. So in this case, you subtract 40 on the cells with minus, then you add the same 40 only on the cells with plus, meaning that you'll add, you subtract 40 there to get 0, subtract 40, you get 130, then the 40 is added on this cell and on that cell to get 340. Now notice that you don't add anything on this other cell because there is no sign on the unit cost associated with that cell. So the revised allocation then takes this form. Then if you were to work out the cost, the total cost of that allocation, you'll find that it's 460, which is now an improvement from the previous iteration. So next we want to check if this new revised allocation is optimal. So again, to check for optimality, we must find the improvement indices of the empty cells. So the improvement index for the root from A to 1 is plus 5. Then let's work out the improvement index for the root from A to 2. So you start by tracing the closed path, then you work out the improvement index. So you note that both improvement indices are positive, which then means that the current allocation is optimal, because if you're to revise the allocation, then it means that the cost will increase instead of reducing. For example, if you allocate anything on this route, this plus 7 means that allocating an extra unit on this route will result in the cost increasing by 7 units of currency per unit. So if you allocate 10 extra units on the route, then the cost will increase by 7. So then it means that the current allocation is optimal, or it gives the optimal solution.